salutations, my children! Time to continue on the story of everyone's favorite little killer dolls, Andre Toulon's legacy, and their puppet master. When last we left off, the puppets and their master, Anthony Gallagher, had finally defeated Anapa, the demon responsible for the power to transfer souls into puppets to begin with. We begin with a bit of a teaser for things to come. Someone who has been waking up in other people's bodies. Only to be murdered by puppets, by Camille, who's in the middle of stabbing people in a restaurant, and even with Neil Gallagher, father of Anthony and the villain of the first movie. Speaking of Anthony, it has been 6 months since the end of the last storyline, and he has been busy. He's figured out how to create the serum that keeps the puppets alive, and with Toulon's notes, found a way around using brains as an ingredient.
Which is good for him, but disappointing for me.
And has been developing his psychic powers, drawing in the puppets into a mental theater that he can use to have conversations and meetings. Although Toulon never seems to come to the theater. Meanwhile, a couple named John and Cindy Mapplethorpe have purchased the Bodega Bay Inn and refurbished it, making it into a viable hotel again, and things couldn't be better! Well, as long as you're a good person anyway. If you're a bad person, Anthony threatens you with the puppets. Like when an abusive man who is more than a bit freaked out when Blade slashes at his foot. In addition, someone in a car crash gets to the hotel. The Mapplethorpes, being kind, even treating Anthony like a son after they found him squatting in the hotel, let the man stay for one night as he tries to figure out what has happened to him. Anthony doesn't trust him and has the puppets follow him. And he goes outside and digs up a box that had been buried near the hotel. And while his father meets Camille for the first time, the mysterious man passes Anthony and calls him by name. But that's neither here nor there, for more importantly, Torch shows up without a head! Investigating, he finds Leech Woman and Decapitron equally decapitated. The souls of the puppets have no explanation, not helped by the lack of the Toulon's presence in the theater. However, while the soul for Shredder Khan claims that he will investigate this, it seems he recognizes the man and even helps him, providing him a special ring. While a group of luchadors arrive to stay at the inn, one even spotting Pinhead and giving him a tiny luchador mask, the mysterious man finds the abusive husband from earlier and murders him, seemingly using Blade and Tunneler to do so. Neil Gallagher gets Camille to join forces with him, which involves slicing her dummy body in half. After the manager of the luchadors tries to assault Cindy Mapplethorpe, Anthony decides to take justice into his own hands, having Blade and Pinhead murder him. Meanwhile, we discover what it was that the mysterious man used to kill the abuser. The Retro Puppets! Something is sadly wrong with Anthony, though, for while the luchadors discover him over the manager's body, he starts ranting to the souls of the puppets, proclaiming that they should never have let anyone come to the hotel. And he wants them all dead, unleashing the puppets on the hotel's customers. The luchadors, whom Anthony was a fan of, try to convince him to stop this, but they too sadly fall prey to his anger. Cindy spots all this and cannot believe what he has done. But then the mysterious man comes out and reveals that he is Andre Toulon. After suggesting what they do with the bodies, he reveals that he has been bouncing from body to body for 6 months now, starting during the fight with Anapa. But since Decapitron was only damaged last night, who has been in it? Well, we soon see, as a puppet that has been stalking around the hotel during the storyline takes Decapitron's head and attaches a new head and arm to it. Those of one of Anapa's puppets. Yes, Anapa himself has possessed the body, and his servant in this puppet body is Madame Adon, the fortune teller from earlier in the Puppet Master comics, who had separated the puppets into human bodies. Cindy tearfully asks Anthony and the puppets to leave. They can't have anything like this in the place, especially after they have invested all of their money into the inn. Andre reunites with the souls of the others, and they make it clear that Anthony needs to part ways with them. The weight of the Puppet Master is a heavy one, and many of their former masters have fallen to it, which has led them to kill said masters, and they do not want to have to do that to Anthony. He checks himself back in at the Baldiston Institute and asks to be put in solitary confinement. But it seems Director Crow has her own agenda, as she is working for the Nazis from the Axis Trilogy, who have been amassing quite the collection of their own puppets. While the puppets begin a hunt for their own new enemy, Andrew sets out for West Virginia, seeking something that had been stolen from him a long time ago.
Anthony may be out as the puppet master, but the puppets themselves aren't out just yet. So don't cut your strings just yet, my children, for we shall revisit the puppet master at some point.